Welcome to this short video about IEEE 802.11, which I will go through as an example of a MAC layer protocol. So the purpose of this video is for you to have knowledge of IEEE 802.11 as an example of a MAC protocol. If we look at the IEEE 802.11 standard, we can say that it's divided basically into a MAC and into a physical layer, and we'll here be looking at the MAC layer. And what we also see, just to have it for the completeness, is I put a figure here demonstrating two applications communicating with each other, but one is using 802.11 and one is using 802.3, so Ethernet. So basically, they go through a gateway which is communicating between the these two kind of networks. Okay, so let's look at 802.11. So here we have virtual sensing, so we have CSMA, carrier sense multiple access, and we have collision avoidance. So as we have seen it in some of the previous videos, the first thing we'll do if I want to communicate, so let's say that A wants to send data to B, is that A will send a request to send, and B will then reply with a confirmation that A can be sending. So that's a clear to send, the CTS. So when A is sending the RTS, then everyone who can hear A will notice that now something is going on, so he should remain silent. That is why C is establishing the NAV, the network allocation vector. The challenges, as we also have seen before, is that it might be that not everyone can hear A. So here we have a D, which obviously don't get the information from A. The good thing is that when we get the clear to send from B, then D can hear this clear to send and uses that for establishing the network allocation vector. And the network allocation vector is based on the information in the RTS and CTS, which is also telling how long time we actually are going to need to have the channel. So now we have reserved the channel for us, and then A can go ahead and send the data, and B can go ahead and send the acknowledgement, and once that acknowledgement is received, then the spectrum is again free to use for everyone. So the way it can be implemented is that we need, once the acknowledgement has been sent, so the spectrum is free again, or the medium is free again, then we actually need to have some kind of order for how to negotiate the reservations. And the first thing is that we have a short interframe spacing, meaning that here we can send a control frame or a next fragment of something already going on. So that's an opportunity to kind of keep the medium. Then there is, if that does not happen within a certain amount of time, then we also allow for priority interframe spacing. And if that doesn't trigger anything, then we allow for what is called DIFS, so the distributed coordination function interframe spacing. If that also doesn't keep the medium busy, then we have an extended interference spacing. And in all these different periods of time, we can send different kinds of frames. So the idea is to kind of prioritize when we can send which type of frames. Then we have a look at the operational processes basically by an example. So the network allocation vector is a time field which indicates the duration of the current transmission. And then we have backup procedure to randomize access of the channel. So what we see is that the medium is busy. Then there is the DIFS time. And if we try to send something during this time, then we will be backing off. And this backing off is a random time assignment. And when that has passed, then the sender can send his request to send. When he sent his request to send, then the other stations will start to enable this network allocation vector based on either the RTS or the CTS. So after the CTS has been received by the sender, he will start sending the data, and then at the end, when he finishes sending the data, there is a SIFS time which can be used for sending or triggering when to send the acknowledgement. And when the acknowledgement has been sent, then the medium is free again, and we have again this priority of times, so we can start sending the diff frames, if any, and continue with the different priorities. So that was the end of this video. If you have any questions, then don't hesitate to ask. Thanks.